Hi. I know it's been a minute. I've been away for a minute from the YouTube. And to be honest with you, I just needed to take a break. I needed some time. And I don't really have a script today. I just want to just chat. I want to talk about a few things. I've talked about a few developments and some change for almost a year now. It'll be a year, April 20th. I've had the channel. We've been talking about toxic workplaces and leaving toxic workplaces. And I have to admit that sometimes staying away and out of a toxic workplace and even identifying a toxic workplace can be kind of difficult, even for me. Okay? Even for me. And I am not going to get into details right now, but I will talk about a situation in which I found myself in, surprisingly. But thank God for Dr. Moni Norrington Sands. And you hear me talk about her all the time. Her channel is called Lifting As We Climb Consulting Wellness Services. And I will put a link to her channel in the description box below. I attended her coaching program, which was very, very helpful. I found it very valuable. It really, really helped me to kind of identify some things about myself that I kind of didn't really know, or maybe I knew but didn't accept them. And I'm not going to get into details, and I'm not trying to sound cryptic. But I do believe in releasing things in season. Okay. I just really wanted to get back on and say, I'm okay. I'm cool. I just needed to step away for a minute. And I do want to remind you that you are valuable. And I'm saying that to you, and I'm also saying it to me, because sometimes we can get ourselves in situations to where we're trying to help others to the detriment of ourselves. And what I mean by that is sometimes we can put ourselves out there, and people who we are trying to assist, they don't even appreciate it. They don't recognize the effort that you're making, and they don't care. And it's so hard for somebody like me not to internalize that, because I am so accustomed to tying my self-worth to what I produce and to the quality of what I produce. I'm so used to tying myself to that when you get a situation where you feel that you're not appreciated, it makes you feel a kind of way. And it made me feel a kind of way. But I'm cool now, and I've made some decisions and I've made some adjustments. Pretty excited about it. But as somebody told me this evening, I'm one of these people I have to find out for myself, I guess. And that's not always a good place to be in, right? We can learn. We can learn from what other people's mistakes. We can learn from our prior mistakes. And I've said this quote before, that a person who's not wise, they don't learn from their mistakes. A smart person learns from their own mistakes, but a wise person learns from other people's mistakes. And we want to be wise. We want to be wise. And even though I do this channel and I talk about things, and to some people I sound profound, to other people, you see my comments, not so profound, I'm still learning and I'm still trying to understand and navigate this season of my life as well. And so I am having to make adjustments, modifications, and pivots. And that's okay. That's okay. I am showing myself grace. And that means that if I'm showing myself grace, I have every right to expect grace from others. And I do. I expect other people to show me grace. And I also, going along with that, like to give other people grace. What I am finding out is I'm at a point in my life where I'm not interested in putting up with no ridiculous stuff, ridiculous actions of others, or accepting the projections of others onto me. I'm just not interested in doing that. And I'm not going to do it. I'm not going to do it in my family. I'm not going to do it on the job. I'm not going to do it in a relationship. I just have decided that I am not interested in being a doormat, the emotional doormat of other people. I'm just not going to do it. I was not created to be the doormat for other people. And you weren't created to be the doormat for other people. And many of you already know that, but some of you may not. Because as Black women, we're taught to hang in there and try to work it out and think of the long term and all this stuff at our detriment, at our own detriment. And I'm saying, no, stop all the dumb stuff. We don't need to continue being involved in situations that are detrimental to us. And when I say detrimental, it could be detrimental emotionally, it could be detrimental physically, it could be detrimental spiritually. And for me, what I'm finding is that if something does not align with me emotionally, physically, most of all spiritually, like the kids say, it's a no for me. It's a no. And it doesn't matter who it is. So know that one, you don't have to put up with the dumb stuff. Okay. And I'm trying to get in heaven, so I'm not saying another word. You don't have to put up with it. You just don't. And you should not. You are not anybody's emotional doormat. And when you see that people have, and I don't want to use the word problems, I'm going to say challenges. Sometimes you can help people if it is not going to impact you adversely in an emotional or a physical or a spiritual way. I think that a lot of times as Black women, we find ourselves in the situation of being the rescuer. And sometimes we are called to be the rescuer, but we're not called to be the rescuer to everyone, all the time, all at once, like the movie. We're not. We just are not. And so we need to ensure that we protect our emotions, our physical well-being, and our spiritual peace at all times. We have a right to that. God said in the Bible that He wished above all things that you and me would prosper, even as our soul prospers. That's what that means. So I just want to say thank you for hanging on in there with me. I'm sorry I had to take a little break. I should say sorry, not sorry, but I'm back and I'll start back posting regularly. I have some exciting things I want to talk to you about, some channel changes that I've made. You may have noticed some changes on the homepage. I'll be reorganizing that a bit and kind of just rearranging some stuff. But again, remember, you're not anybody's emotional doormat or punching bag. None of it. Okay? Remember that when you were created valuable. I didn't even say my name. This is Colette Elizabeth. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up. And if you want more content like this, go ahead and subscribe to the channel. Hit that notification bell so that you are advised when I upload new videos. And I will talk to you soon.